projects. We lived in Mohegan Ave. We lived on Morris Ave in Second Ave in the Bronx. We lived all over New York. You know what I'm saying? I lived in Queens. I lived all over New York. And I got adopted in Jersey. I got adopted in Williamsburg, New Jersey. I ain't never lied. That's about my story. Because if I lie, it ain't gonna be no good. I can't inspire people now. I'll be straight up with people. And people act like, yo, I knew you. You don't know me. I never knew you. I got adopted by the bishop, but I wasn't there long because I got locked up. First, they put me in a group home. Then I went to a residence, then I went to juvie, then I went to max security. I know where I went. Then from there, before they let me out, they put me in a crazy house. Because I had tried to kill myself in jail. Like, I know what they doing. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, anybody who can talk to me can see my head wrapped tight. You feel what I'm saying? Like, my head is very wrapped tight. You see what I'm saying? So, you can't say I got mental issues. Like, with my head wrapped tight. You feel what I'm saying? How everything I'm saying makes sense. So, and then so at the end of the day, I can see how people take all the negative about me and extract it and try to, you know, create a shadow being. And I get it. You know what I'm saying? But the truth about the matter is I learned a lot in prison, man. I learned a lot. You know what I'm saying? I had been in situations where I had to fight the whole time I was in prison. Like the first fucking year I was in prison, I was fighting. You see what I'm saying? And I lost the knuckle fight. My whole knuckle gone. I don't got a knuckle on my pinky. His pinky knuckle's gone. Ain't no knuckle there. I used to get boxing practices all the time. Right here, I had a little temper. You feel me? Like I had a bad temper. I had to learn how to control my anger. I had a bad temper, man. I used to be an R&B singer. I used to aspire to be an R&B singer. Like, I had a situation, right, with these dudes. Check this out. So somebody, so, I told somebody this is the story today, right, so check it out. When you get out of jail, you got a different mindset. Like, when I first got out of jail, everything was disrespect. In jail, everything is about respect. It's all about respect and disrespect. If a nigga disrespect, gotta check him immediately. I don't care. The littlest thing.